When botanists study the dispersal of seeds or pollen, and when zoologists study the dispersal of animals, they find the same general pattern. Most individuals barely move at all. Some move short distances, and a few move long distances, with very few moving very long distances. And this pattern is called a leptokurtic distribution. Those individuals that barely move at all or move a short distance maintain the local population. But those that travel a long distance bring about the change in range, the colonization of islands, the dispersal of genetic material. This plant here is called Proliferous pink. For a long time, it was just known in the UK from one location, Cranwich Camp in Norfolk. And last summer, I was delighted to discover this new colony near Mildenhall, 20 kilometres from Cranwich Camp. So some way down the tail of the leptokurtic distribution. And Darwin was fascinated by this long distance dispersal and wanted to understand the mechanism. So he took a pigeon that had been shot, he floated it in seawater for a month, and then cut it open, took out the seeds and planted them, and many of them were viable. So perhaps corpses floating around is one long distance mechanism. He had correspondents who were shooting migrant birds as they arrived on the south coast, windchats and wheatears, and occasionally noticed balls of soil attached to their feet, which again could have held seeds. So these are unlikely processes, but the sort of rare event that on odd occasions can produce this long distance dispersal. And remember, it is those that produce the dramatic changes in distribution or evolutionary change.